In this video we will define axiom and talk briefly about why it is different from a postulate. In addition, we will review the concepts of theorem, lemma, and corollary. Finally, we'll talk about the enormous importance of axioms as the foundation for the development of scientific theories. Let's begin. Let's recall that a proposition is a sentence which is either true or false, but not both at the same time. If you stop to think about this definition for a moment, you'll realize that all concepts are, indeed, propositions which are always true. Now, it is important to note that some propositions need to be proven first before they can be accepted as true, while others are so obvious that can be assumed as true without any proof. We'll take, for the time being, the following definition of axiom. Axiom is commonly defined as a proposition that is so clear and evident, that can be assumed as true without a demonstration. In other words, an axiom is a concept so obvious that it is agreed upon without controversy. So, axioms are assumed as true without a demonstration. This notion of axiom was initiated by Aristotle in the ancient Greece, and afterwards it was used widely by Euclid, among others. Some authors use indistinctively the word postulate when referring to axioms. However, here we'll make a distinction by saying that axioms are used as the foundation for a whole science, while postulates are used as the foundation for only an area or division within a science. After the publication of Foundations of Geometry by David Hilbert in 1899 and the discoveries made by other mathematicians in the early 20th century, the definition of axiom has been reconsidered. In natural sciences, an axiom that complies with nature is called a law. In mathematics, a theorem is a proposition deducted from previously accepted axioms. The process of logical deduction of theorems is called demonstration. Now, a theorem can be deducted from axioms and/or one or more other theorems which have been previously deducted from axioms and/or other proven theorems. Sometimes, in order to demonstrate a theorem, it is necessary to demonstrate some other concepts first. These previous demonstrations are called lemmas. Nevertheless, you should notice that lemmas, in general, are not as important as theorems and are used only as previous steps in order to complete the demonstration of a theorem. On the other hand, sometimes there are concepts that follow directly from theorems with little or no further work. These are called corollaries. But then again, considering their impact on the science to which they belong, corollaries are not as important as theorems. Finally, the set of axioms, related theorems, and their lemmas and corollaries, if any, comprise a theory. Thus, we'll define theorem as a proposition that has been demonstrated on the basis of axioms and/or one or more other previously proven theorems. A lemma is a proposition that is proven true, and then used as a stepping stone during the demonstration of a theorem. A corollary is a proposition that follows from a theorem with little or no further work. And a theory is a set of axioms, related theorems deducted from them, and the lemmas and/or corollaries of those theorems, if any. Thus, axioms can be redefined as a collection of propositions not contradicting each other, which are so clear and evident that can be assumed as true without a demonstration, and from which theories are constructed. From now on, in this site, unless otherwise stated, we'll assume this definition of axiom. It should be clear then that axioms are, indeed, fundamental or primitive concepts. However, as the set of axioms used as foundation for a science should include only the concepts that are absolutely necessary and not more, then it is clear that while all axioms are fundamental or primitive concepts, not all fundamental or primitive concepts are used as axioms.